Welcome to today's online service. Grace to you and peace from God, our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us look to God in prayer. Almighty God, whose blessed Son prayed that all who believed in him might be one, grant that we who celebrate the union of churches in South India may with one heart and soul present ourselves for your service and bear witness to your life. Through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen. To the glory of God, and to begin our worship, let us sing the hymn which is screened. Save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace before. Let us pray together.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against thee and against our neighbor, in thought and word and deed. Through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are heartily sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve thee in newness of life. To the glory of thy name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now hear the Bible readings.
வாசிக்கும்படியாக தெரிந்து கொள்ளப்பட்ட வேத பாடம் அப்போஸ்தலனாகிய பவுல் எபேசியருக்கு எழுதின நிருபம் 4 அதிகாரம் வசனங்கள் 1 முதல் 6 வரை அடங்கியுள்ள தேவனுடைய வார்த்தையை கேளுங்கள். எபேசியர் 4 வசனங்கள் 1 முதல் புதிய ஏற்பாட்டின் பக்கம் 266. ஆதலால் கர்த்தர் நிமித்தம் கட்டுண்டவனாகிய நான் உங்களுக்கு சொல்லுகிற புத்தி என்னவெனில், நீங்கள் அழைக்கப்பட்ட அழைப்புக்கு பாத்திரவான்களாய் நடந்து மிகுந்த மனத்தாழ்மையும் சாந்தமும் நீடிய பொறுமையும் உடையவர்களாய் அன்பினால் ஒருவரை ஒருவர் தாங்கி சமாதான கட்டினால் ஆவியின் உரிமையை காத்து கொள்வதற்கு ஜாக்கிரதையாய் இருங்கள். உங்களுக்கு உண்டான அழைப்பினாலே நீங்கள் ஒரே நம்பிக்கைக்கு அழைக்கப்பட்டது போல ஒரே சரீரமும் ஒரே ஆவியும் உண்டு. ஒரே கர்த்தரும் ஒரே விசுவாசமும் ஒரே ஞானஸ்நானமும் எல்லாருக்கும் ஒரே தேவனும் பிதாவும் உண்டு. அவர் எல்லார் மேலும் எல்லாரோடும் உங்கள் எல்லாருக்குள்ளும் இருக்கிறவர். பாடம் முடிந்தது. கிறிஸ்துவே உமக்கு மகிமை உண்டாவதாக.
Hear the word of God as it is written in the Gospel according to St. John in the 17th chapter beginning at the 20th verse. St. John chapter 17 verses 20 to 26. I pray not only for them but also for those who believe in me because of their message. I pray that they may all be one. Father, may they be in us just as you are in me and I am in you. May they be one so that the world will believe that you sent me. I gave them the same glory you gave me, so that they may be one, just as you and I are one. I in them and you in me, so that they may be completely one. In order that the world may know that you sent me and that you love them as you love me. Father, you have given them to me, and I want them to be with me where I am, so that they may see my glory, the glory you gave me, for you loved me before the world was made. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you, and these know that you sent me. I have made you known to them, and I will continue to do so, in order that the love you have for me may be in them, and so that I also may be in them. Here ends the lesson. Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Dearly beloved, today is providentially 27th of September. This is the day when the Church of South India was formed. Before the formation of the Church of South India, there had been visionary leaders who were looking into the churches. They were all divided by denominations. Therefore, they had a vision in order to bring all these churches together and form one church. They worked very hard because they involved the structures to come together. And with their effort, and many years later, more than 20 or 25 years later, there was the intention of denominations of some major churches to come together. And thereby, 4 denominational churches, the Anglican, the Congregationalists, the Presbyterians, and the Methodists, they came together into one union under the umbrella of the Church of South India. When the Church of South India was formed, it became the second largest church than the Roman Catholic Church in India. The Roman Catholic Church was the first, and the second largest church in India was the Church of South India. And later they became member of the Anglican Communion, and they became the member of the National Council of Churches in India, NCCI, and also became the member of the World Council of Churches, WCC. This is a symbol of divine unity. All the structures of the four denominations gave way in order to become one church. And this is the great message that we receive today. It is not about the church, but about the unity, the union of churches coming together. And therefore, beloved, today we will meditate the unity or the union of churches in three different aspects. And they are, firstly, church is truth bearer. Secondly, church as torch bearer. And thirdly, church is trend setter. Let us meditate these major points, major aspects, one by one. Firstly, church is truth bearer. In the gospel reading that we have just heard read from John chapter 17 and verses 20 to 26, or rather the three chapters in John, chapter 15 and chapter 16 and chapter 17 of St. John, is the prayer of Jesus. Just before Jesus was crucified, he prayed to the Father. And particularly in John chapter 17 and verse 21, Jesus prayed, "Let that they may all be one. Let that they may all be one." And this is the unity for which Jesus was praying for. He prayed for oneness. In fact, when we look into the Old Testament, we know that there is the Jewish confession of faith, which they call it as Sema. It is found in Deuteronomy chapter 6 and 4 onwards. Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 4 says, "Listen, Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. The Lord our God, the Lord is one." This is the major factor for the confession of the Jewish faith on unity. God is one. In those days there were many gods. We know that Abraham, who was in the setup of worshipping many gods, when Yahweh called him, he obeyed to follow the Old Testament God Yahweh. Therefore, he left his place. He clinged on to the promise of God, the one God, and he set his way to the promised land without knowing where he was going. But he clinged on to the promise of one God. And this is the unity that we find in God's self. Even when we take the concept of marriage, when we meditate on the institution of marriage, it is said in Genesis chapter 2 and verse 24, "You will become one flesh." This also is a call to unity. In Ephesians chapter 5 And verses 31 and 32 says, this is a mystery. This refers to marriage. We know that in marriage there are two people, the male and the female, the bridegroom and the bride. And when they come to the institution of holy matrimony, the Bible says they are one flesh. Paul says in Ephesians chapter 5 verses 31 and 32, this is a mystery. Indeed, it is a mystery. Because the truth is, there is oneness. The truth of the church in wedding ceremony, in a wedding occasion, the message that the church preaches, the truth that the church would put forth before the couple is union, is unity. And therefore the church is always the bearer of truth. And what is this truth? This truth is the truth of unity. There are separations in families. There are divisions among family members. There is division in an institution. There is separation in society on various backgrounds. The religion, the caste, the creed, the class, the rich, the poor, the educated, the uneducated. And all these are great divisions that we find in the institution of a family as well as in society. What is the message of the church? What is the truth of the church? Unity. The church brings us with the message, unity in diversity. And therefore, it is the truth bearer. Secondly, the church is torch bearer. We know that a torch gives light. Light dispels darkness. And therefore, Jesus invited every one of us to be the light to the world. Jesus told his disciples, you are the light to the world. Jesus told his disciples, you are the salt of the earth. In the first reading that we have just heard read from Ephesians chapter 4 and verses 1 to 6, and particularly in verse 4, Paul says, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. This also is a message of unity. This message is also the message or the gospel of becoming one. One Lord, one faith, one baptism. During the time of St. Paul, there were converts. There were people who had different faith. They all came to the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Therefore, Paul says that there is one God. Paul says that there is one faith, and that faith is on Jesus Christ. And then he also said that there is one sacrament, and that one sacrament is baptism. And therefore the baptism was adult baptism, since they were converts for the very first time to the kingdom of God. The church is the torch bearer. In fact, the church needs humility to be a torch bearer. It needs a gentleness like Jesus to be a torch bearer. What is humility? In those days, in the Greek dictionary, there is no word for humility. There was no word at all. They only knew conquering. That means that they conquer by war. They knew only conquering and crowning. And that is the message that was there in the culture, in the language, in the dictionary, in the Greek world. After the coming of Jesus Christ, Jesus said that, Father, you are in me, I am in you. And that is the motto, the central verse in the Church of South India. And that is from St. John's Gospel, chapter 17 and verse 21. We are one with you. Because that was the prayer of Jesus. Lord, you are in me and I am in you. And my prayer is that they may also be with us. This is the message which was preached by Jesus. The message of humility. The message of gentleness. And therefore, this word humility was later added into the dictionary, the Greek dictionary, in the 4th century. Till then, people were not aware of how to be gentle and to be humble. That is the quality of a Christian. Gentleness or meekness is not a weakness. What is the opposite of gentleness? It is anger. We are all angry at different times. But Jesus does not say that we should not have anger at all. Rather, Jesus always advocated to humility and gentleness because he practiced it all his life. At the same time, he also got angry at a particular time when he went into the temple of Jerusalem and saw the money changers and saw that they were making profit and making the holy place a marketplace. Jesus was angry with them. He whipped them out of the temple. He said, "This is my Father's house, but you have made it a den of robbers. You had made it a place of making profit. You had made this place a marketplace." But otherwise, he was always gentle. He was always humble. And that is the message that comes to the church. The church need to be humble. The church need to be gentle. And have the anger to face out the evil one with anger. It should be in the right proportion. And that is the message of torch bearer. Jesus taught his disciples to be gentle and to be humble and to be meek, because Jesus himself maintained it until his death on the cross. He was gentle before Pilate. He was humble before the people when they accused him of several accusations which were not authentic. Jesus was humble. And therefore, the message that the church proclaims is the message of torch bearing. Torch bearing is upholding the qualities of oneness, the qualities of humility and gentleness. Thirdly, the church is trendsetter. As we had just meditated in the beginning, we referred the Jewish creed, which is said that God is one, the Lord is one, in Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 4. And also in the institution of marriage, Jesus said, "You will become one flesh," in Genesis chapter 2, verse 24. And also St. Paul says in Ephesians chapter 5, verses 31 and 32, referring the institution of wedding as a mystery. Because trend setting is to set an example to the world. The formation of the Church of South India is the message of unity. And this is the truth of Jesus. And this is the torch of the church, which is said that we stand in unity. Because God is one, we stand with God. We always need to be in union with God. But why are we not able to be in union with Christ? It is because of the evil one who plays a major role, destroying, damaging wherever there is unity. Therefore, we need to identify the evil one at the various places that the evil one is at work. If the evil one is at work in our lives, in our family, in our institution, identify the evil one and chase the evil one away in order to be one with God. And that is trend setting. The trend that the church would set is to be in union with God and also to drive away the evil one. This is the message that the church is trend setter. Therefore, beloved, in conclusion, we have said that the church need to be in union with Christ. The Church of South India is a model. It is a witness of unity. Because the various denominations were able to give up their structures, give up their positions. Even some of them were bishops and they gave up their positions in order to be one with Christ. Because this is the witness to the world. This is what Christ has taught his disciples and the people of God to do. And therefore, firstly, the church is the truth bearer, the truth of unity. Secondly, it is the torch bearer. The qualities of truth, gentleness and meekness. And thirdly, the church is a model, the trend setter of unity. Where there is unity, there is Christ. Where there is a division, there is the evil one. Therefore, beloved, let the formation of the Church of South India be a witness, be a model to the whole world to say that we are one in Christ Jesus. Amen. Let us profess our faith through the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Let us sing together the closing hymn as a screed, during which time the offertory will be received. Service. We thank you for bringing us together in union with Christ. We thank you for the last Sunday of this month of September. And as providentially today is the 27th of September, it is the formation day of the Church of South India. What a great witness and what a great message that you have of the church union to the whole world. Lord, we pray as we had just meditated, the church to be the truth bearer, upholding unity with Christ. The church as torch bearer, upholding the qualities of Jesus Christ, the gentleness, the humbleness, the humility and meekness. And the church as trendsetter, a model, a witness to the whole world that we would want everyone to be in union with Christ. Lord, this is the greatest message that you had preached through your life in this world. When you were walking on earth, there was oneness of you with the Father and the Father with you. And you had prayed for all of us to be in unity, to be in union with yourself. Help, O God, that we would serve you, that we would be with you in unity. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for all who are partaking in this online service. We pray, O God, that you will bestow the aspect of unity in our hearts, that we always would like to be in union, to be in peace, and not in separation, not in division, and not in conflict. Lord, we thank you for the offertory that we have received. We pray that you will bless all of them who had offered the offertory. bless the offertory which has been received, and help that this is used for the extension of your kingdom. We pray for all those who have supplications and applications to you. Lord, we pray that you will listen to their cry and answer to their prayers. Grant them health, grant them happiness, grant them the joy in their hearts and homes. We pray, O God, for those who celebrate their birthdays, those who celebrate their wedding anniversaries, those who celebrate their special days or remember their special days. We pray that you will bless them abundantly. Make this week a blessing for us. And as we begin a new month in the course of this week, we pray, O God, that you will help us to enter into a brand new month. Give us health, give us happiness. Thank you for being with us throughout this worship service. And we ask all of this in and through the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. May the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with all of us this day and forevermore.